2021 Volkswagen Tiguan Review, Highway Haven.
But before we start, please support us by pressing the like and subscribe buttons, so that we can continue to provide information about car and motorcycle news. Also turn on the bell button to get the latest updates. Your support means a lot to us. Thank you.
A funny thing happened when the second generation Volkswagen Tiguan went on sale. It was a hit. Oh sure, the Tiguan, a nonsense portmanteau of, we kid you not, Tiger, and Iguana, is a bit player in the huge compact crossover segment. But when VW phased out the old model in 2017 and introduced the new model in 2018, sales went from 47,000 units to 103,000. Like we said, a hit. We didn't need 700 miles of highway driving to understand why consumers have bought over 100,000 Tiguans annually since that 2018 model year. But then Volkswagen invited us to a winter drive of the new Golf R in Michigan's Upper Peninsula and offered a 2021 Tiguan for the journey. Here's what we learned after driving up and down Interstate 75 for 9 hours in a range-topping SEL Premium R-Line. The Tiguan is due for a refresh in 2022, but we only say that because it's what the calendar dictates. The current exterior is clean and attractive but isn't nearly as dull as the US spec Passat. While the cabin is a simple place chock full of high-quality materials and pleasant detailing, in contrast to the more expensive and simultaneously cheaper Atlas. The exterior's crisp, straight lines contrast with pleasant styling elements, such as the faux side grilles on the front fender and the detailing in the LED headlights. Gloss black accents in the sporty front and rear fascia, exclusive to the R-Line trim, match neatly with our tester's pure white paint. That same trim includes flashy 20-inch wheels, a full inch larger than on the standard SEL. This is a nice crossover, with none of the polarizing flare present in the competition. That's neither a good or bad thing, but it is refreshing. Speaking of polarizing, the saffrono and black leather upholstery is, it's a look. The upholstery is vivid, almost lurid, like an overzealous mix of classic tan and red coloring, although it does broadly match the tin of saffron sitting in our spice rack. The color scheme the most eye-catching element in a cabin that relies on simple, logical design and high-quality materials instead of excessive tinsel. The thin-spoked, flat-bottom steering wheel, upright center stack, and conventional layout for the various climate controls are both unique in today's market and are easy to adjust to. Again, this is just a nice place to hang out. Driving a vehicle 700 miles means becoming intimately familiar with things like seat comfort and noise control. Thankfully, the Tiguan impresses on both counts. The front seats feel like they could have come from a GTI, offering up huge support via the thick side bolsters and ample adjustments. In particular, leg support is excellent and the seatback is so good we barely fiddled with the lumbar. There's plenty of padding too, so our stomach and bladder dictated when we stopped rather than a need to get out and stretch. Your author made the northerly trek alone, so the backseat's only occupants were a pair of muddy duck boots and a backpack. Still, throwing open those rear doors exposes plenty of legroom. With the driver's seat set for a 6'2" driver, the rear bench is a capacious place. Volkswagen quotes 38.7 inches of second row legroom, which is a figure only a few vehicles in the class can beat. We're looking at you Honda CR-V and your 40.4 inches. And on the cargo front, our two-row Tiguan offers up 37.6 cubic feet with the seats in place and 73.5 with them folded. Both numbers upstage the otherwise roomy Honda.
Thanks for watching. Drop a like, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe to watch more videos like this.